Hello everybody, and welcome back to The Journey. In today's video, we're just going to go over some coins and you know what I'm going to be putting them in. This is a little album that I recently picked up from Amazon, and this one holds, I think, 120 coins. So I figured since I need to put them in here anyway, it'd be a good time to go over some of the stuff and let y'all see some of the things that I've tinkered with, and that'll get you up to date on what I've been doing. So these are quarters. Pennies. These are just some that I just plan on saving. I've got some barber dimes and quarters and some large cents and things like that. So I have thousands of other pennies that I need to go through. I have a few different containers. So I have a 5-gallon jug that we've been putting pennies in for a long time. And that is this container right here. And I have started pulling coins out of that. And you can see from this container here, this one is all of the zinc pennies from that I have sorted. And then this container is all of the copper coins that I have sorted from there. And as I sort through all those pennies, I will be sorting, you know, keeping the copper ones separated. I've got some other ones sitting over there that have been sorted by year, but I haven't gone through them and looked for varieties or anything like that yet. Now, of course, I do have a few that I have gone through and decided to keep. Most of these will have some sort of a tagging on them, and I have not had these verified, like this one, 1960 double die. I need to go back and just double check things. But yeah, we're going to go ahead and get them in here, and we'll see how things go, and then we'll go over the ones that I've got. Alright, so I have taken those and put them in. We got two pages, both with 9 coins on each page. And like I said, I'm just a pure amateur. I have no clue what I'm doing. All these pennies I have found, except for this one. This one, he had it in 10, and he had it on his discount bin, and he sold it to me for a couple bucks. So we just got that little guy, and it's actually missing one of the letters in the date. But I don't know a whole lot about it. But anyway, we've got the 70D with the floating roof. Got a couple of those. Got an, all three of them are the missing FG. And these, you know, I got a couple here that look to be double dies under the microscope. The small date, 74 off center strike, which is really no big deal, but I like them when they're kind of offset like that. Just, you know, just a little meaningless error, really. And an 82 DDR. DDR is double die reverse, and DDO is double die obverse, and of course obverse being the front of the coin or the head side. And then these I just grabbed because, as you can see, I got it written on there, high grade. They're just in really good shape considering, you know, found in circulation. These did not come out of rolls, they all came out of pocket change. So yeah, they're in really, really good shape, so I figured, you know what, wouldn't hurt to grab them and set them aside. So anyway, that's what I've got for the pennies here, and I think I'm going to do this little stack right here. We're going to throw these in. All right, and there we go. Just slapped them in there. I've got the 3 bicentennials, all found in circulation. I've got, this is just a random Sacagawea that I found, and I forgot I'd even had these two. They were floating around in the safe over there, just 79 Susan B's, so they'll be actually probably end up in the other book over there, one of them anyway. I haven't even taken the time to check the mint marks on them. But yeah, that's what I've got for those. I'm gonna, you know, just get the rest of the stuff in here, and we'll be back in just a minute. All right, I have put the large cents in. These are the ones I showed in the video the other day. And, you know, of course, they're nice and flipped up. I still haven't taken the time to try and get this one dated. But they are in there. And I do have some more in here that I picked up. This is just some random ones I picked up out of that coal bin again. Eventually, I'll go through these, get things flipped up. There's even some Australian coins in here. There we go. So, yeah, I need to go through these, and we'll do a video on those later. But yeah, now I'm going to put in the barber and bust coins, and we'll go from there. All right, so I got those in. We've got a few seated coins and some bust coins. Any prices you see on here, I did get them much cheaper than that. This guy here, I think I paid 12 bucks for, 250. I don't remember all these things, but this one here is actually a love token. So that was pretty cool. When I first saw it, I had no clue what I was looking at. But anyway, yep, we've got we've got a few of those. And when I do my silver count for how much silver I have ounces wise, I do not count these, even though they are here, and they're, of course, they are part of my collection. But I don't count this as part of my silver stack. I've got a couple of halves as well, and all these busts that I've got here, I actually got those at a pawn shop, and he sold them to me at, I think, 16 and a half times face. I did a video on it when it first happened, or when I got them, and it's been well over a month ago. You can go back and see that, but I think it was like 16 and a half times face, so I grabbed all the bust coins that he had. So, yeah, or the barber coins, I'm sorry. But, yep, that's those in, and I think I might have enough room when I'll get those quarters put in. We'll be right back. And all right, yeah, we got most of those into the book. I've got a few extras. These I got to go into the other books, the binders. These are just really, really clean examples of some of these coins. And this is actually one of the Ghost Comet ones, but it's in really, really nice condition. And that's what these are. And then, these are just some more. I find these Ghost Comet ones all the time. So these are really common in my opinion. I've probably found 50 of them over the last 4 or 5 months. But we got Ghost Comet in there. On this one, the guy on the bow there has 3 legs instead of 2. This one, she has 2 pinkies. Got some die chip errors. Several die chip errors. More die chip. This one is the feeding fingers where the machines were loading the coins and it scratched up the coins or something. I don't know how it works. This one's got basically a broken window, which is a die chip error. And then over here, a couple more die chip errors. You can probably see, you can see that one with your naked eye right there on his lip. And I also have the only W Mint Mark coin that I have found to date. Yeah, but that is it. That's what I've, the stuff that, through all my searching so far, this is what I have found. And, aside from a couple of them that I had picked up. So the other extras there, I'll be putting back into the box. And then this will be ready to receive more. And of course, as things like quarters and whatnot require more space, I'll just get more of these books. They're fairly inexpensive. I can't remember how much it was, but it was like $8, I think, or something like that. So, but anyway, that's what I've got for these flipped up coins. And when I do some more coin roll hunts, I will be adding to these, I'm sure, as I find new things to put under the microscope. So if y'all ever want to see that kind of stuff as I find them, let me know in the comments below, and I'll make sure we do the videos. But just remember, if you do like these videos and content of this nature, hit me a like, give me a subscribe, comment down below, and just, let me know that you want to see more. But until then, thank you for being here, and thank you for taking the time out of your day and sharing it with me. And as always, I do thank you for following along on my silver journey. See you in the next one. God bless.